Now, the world's electronic trash often ends up in huge dump sites in Ghana. Burning it is a health and environmental hazard. Two young games designers from Ghana want to do something about it. For them and the players, this isn't just a game.
Imagine you are a space commander and responsible for keeping Ghana clean. What would you do? This is a trailer for the video game The Chronicles of Klinu. The game is set in Agbogbeloshie, a district in the southwest of central Accra. This area is home to the infamous scrapyard known as Sodom and Gomorrah. It's a vast dumping ground for e-waste. Game developers Prince Andrew Ardayfio and Matthew Hansen grew up in Ghana. They want players to come up with creative solutions to one of their country's biggest challenges, e-waste. Anyone playing the Chronicles of Klinu needs to be on location at the site, interacting directly with the environment. The game deals with the theme of recycling, but in a playful way. Another task players might have to complete is taking pictures to document the pollution.
It's no more the trend where you play games for leisure. We play games like to psych our mentality, to broaden our scope, how we understand things, how we apply whatever we learn in the game.
The Chronicles of Klinu is one part of a mega game called Enter Africa. It consists of 15 different location-based mobile games that are aimed at creating positive social change across the continent.
With Enter Africa, we are looking at a different approach to problem solving. That is through gamification, through game mechanics, through thinking out of the box. And sometimes thinking like there's no box, actually. We want to see that approach to problem solving in Africa.
The game currently focuses on pollution, but Prince Andrew Ardayfio hopes that in the future, the game could tackle all sorts of important issues.
I want to see Africa being sustainable in all areas. We should have a sustainable ecosystem when it comes to business, when it comes to agriculture, when it comes to game development. Every industry, the industrial revolution in Africa must be institutionalized by 2050 and for it to be sustainable on its own, for it to be able to run. So in 2050, with Enter Africa, I want to see Africa be the Ethiopia that we created.
For the moment, this vision of a clean Accra is only a virtual reality. Can gaming help the vision cross over into the real world?
That question goes to Bethlehem Anteneh, an experienced designer from Addis Ababa. So you were involved with this team of developers, games developers, and you actually developed the experience itself. Tell us, can gaming help the real world?
Most definitely. This has been the thing that has been a bit forgotten about having an impact in the real life situations, but this is what we're trying to do to push it in.
So how does the game work? You pick up trash, you document it as well by taking photos, but how do you actually clean up the problem or get rid of the problem?
Yeah, so there are different situations and steps that you go through playing the game, but the core element about the idea that we're trying to say comes from the idea where we want people to understand the situation, the extendency of the situation, because when people live in a situation like that for so long, it almost adapts to something normal. And that's how this has been able to continue for such a long time as it is. And we want to portray the other side of it as well, the contrast of it, so that people understand and see where this is.
So it's about awareness. It's pointing out that this doesn't have to be your everyday. I've been to Accra and I know you see the air pollution, you see the problem, you smell the problem as well of this electronic waste being burnt off, which is just terrible for your health and for the environment. And yet people who live there and experience it every day, they don't know much about it.
No, this is day to day, even better. Well, on the positive side, they try to make things out of it as well to try to find opportunities, but there can be better ways. And this is people who are trying to see a different, better Africa coming to see it and also trying to change the values of that.
And so you get gamers to actually go there and see what it's like and then do something about it.
Exactly. And what's so great about that is when you're playing a game, it's a completely different new world. You're trying to go to a mission to try and see things differently. And that changes the whole dimension of how you see things, yeah.
I can't play the game, though, here in Berlin.
Well, we are trying to work on situations where people anywhere can actually experience a little bit of the situation there, yeah.
But it's basically based on GPS data, so...
Yes.
The game is following you around and knows exactly where you are. How good's the internet connection?
Well,
because surely you would have to have really good internet to run something like that with all that data.
Definitely, but the good point is right now we're using a content management app, which is enabling people, players, to actually download stuff at first at a Wi-Fi space, for example, and then take it on an offline journey. So that helps a lot.
How difficult or how easy was it to develop it then?
Well, we actually had to partner up with people who made the content management. And then afterwards, the scenario was that people like Prince and Matthew devised the way to translate the situation down in Accra. So it wasn't.
And basically, at the end of the day, this is all about, instead of just chasing around Pokemons, which is...
Exactly.
Which is what we all know augmented reality is all about. You're actually getting people to do something meaningful.
And to think about it, yes.
What other examples do you have? Because you said you're interested in expanding this to other African countries.
Yeah, well, currently right now it works with 15 African countries. Mm-hmm. So maybe one of the examples I could give you is on the contrast of cleanliness, Kigali is Africa's cleanest city.
Wow.
And it's growing with the very advancement of the tech hubs. But on the other hand, they have a different problem, which is having people to connect in a very emotional and intimate way. And we are having to discuss that on a game level. And at the end of the journey, people are actually brought in towards to meet the, spoiler alert, the makers of the game. And this is more or less recruitment of like-minded people to come together as a community.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So activism at work in the games world and making a better reality for us. Thank you, Bethlehem, for coming in.
Thank you.